What am I doing? I'm stretching the metal. Stretching the metal. I'm pounding walnuts in it, what I call walnuts. Very rough. Very rough. Do we have the gloves? Yeah, just some kind of welding gloves. I don't walk up to the wheel without gloves on, because if you get your thumb in there, you're gonna remember it for a year maybe, or 6 months, and I don't like that. It says hurt, sometimes I might even say a nasty word. In case some of you don't know who I am, I'm Gene Winfield. I have a shop in Mojave, California. In fact, I have a show there every October. So if any of you ever, you know, out that way or in October, give me a call and come to my car show. And I get people from all over the world, France, Germany, Italy, Australia, New Zealand, you name it, Japan. Anyway, I'm gonna take this and run it through the wheel. Let's get one with a little bit more curve. That's too much at first. How about this one? Yeah, I'm gonna put a wheel, the bottom die in here with just a slight bit of radius, because I'm putting a radius in here. And I'm gonna roll out the walnuts now. Now I'm gonna leave it very loose at first and just roll it back and forth a few times, tighten it up a little bit. And I keep rolling it. You can turn it. Tightening it up again. Now, if you have not ever used a wheel, what I'm doing at the end of each stroke, I turn it very slightly. See, as I turn it, just slightly, and that allows me to walk back and forth across the panel. You see, I do it automatically without thinking. Anyway, now I've got the walnuts out of it. You see, it's pretty smooth, but I want more shape, so I'm gonna pound it again. Now, aluminum will work hardened. It work hardens. The more you pound it, the harder it gets. So after you get up to a certain point, you may want to anneal it. Now, we can't use a torch in here, but the way I anneal it, I'll put this in the vise, put it a corner in the vise, and I'll put soot on there from acetylene only. I put black soot across the panel, acetylene only. Then I turn on a big hot flame, and you go back and forth and you burn the soot off. All that gives you, I mean, all the soot does for you, it shows you so that you don't get it too hot. See, if you didn't have the soot on there, you might get it too hot and burn it, or you know, score it. So you want to be able to go back and forth with an even amount of heat. In fact, quite often I'll use a rosebud, a fairly small rosebud, and you go across it with a nice hot flame, and you go over that. Then you let it cool, and that will soften it. It'll go back to almost zero softness. Now, if we had a cement floor, you can drop aluminum onto a floor. I don't know if it'll work here or not. And you can tell the amount of temper by the ring, by the sound of it. You see? See how that has that certain ring to it? Now, if it was annealed and or softer material, you'd have way less ring. Unbelievable. Did I tell you every day's a school day? She's listening. I can tell. She's listening. Anyway, I'm going to take this and pound a little more walnuts in it. Let's go for the next tighter radius, that one. Go ahead and put that in. I'm stretching it pretty good. Now, when I'm stretching it in the center, it's wrinkling over here a little bit, which I'll show you how we'll straighten that out. I have workshops at my place twice a year. My next workshop will be November 22nd and 23rd in Mojave, California. Now I'm going to put it back in. Now listen to the click when I bring it out. See, that tremendous pressure on that wheel. You can put so much pressure that pretty soon it won't go in, you know. I'll show you an example. See, so I have to roll it to get it in there. Hear the click? Tremendous. So now I've got it fairly smooth in the dome or the blister that I'm developing. And now I'm going to turn it upside down. I'm going to back it off a little bit. Now I'm pulling down just slightly, in a downward pull, just slightly. It helps increase the movement of the metal. And you're going to get the sander ready for me?
Yep, got it all ready.
Thank you. So now I have it fairly flat around the edge, and I have a nice blister. And we're going to clamp it on over here on the side of the table. Push the clamp in that way just a little bit, if you can. Or maybe it's hitting. There, that's better.
Better?
Yeah, that's better. Now I'm going to clamp it on the table, and then quite often I'll use a flat duckbill type vice grips. Duckbill, you know, 3-inch duckbills, I call them. And we put that on the ends just to hold it down. He's going to hold it for me. No, not yet. Yep. Now we have slapping files from Eastwood. You understand that we're in this Eastwood booth. You gotta buy some Eastwood products because they're fabulous. Anyway, slapping file. Now you can use it to bring the metal up or down. Now we have a dent. Now we need some kind of a dolly. What you try to find a dolly that will be very close to that shape. You can use anything you want for a dolly. This dolly has nice compound curve to it. Okay. Hold it down. He's going to hold it down because I'm going to push up with pressure on the dolly from underneath while I'm slapping it. Now you hear it ring. When it's ringing, it's actually moving the metal. If it's rattling, you know, rattling, you're not actually moving the metal. But I took that dolly and I slapped it with a slapping file. Now what do? We put a now we put one from underneath. Same deal. So you can go up or down. Now I look at the highlights and you can read the metal, the filings here. That's why it is a slapping file, because it shrinks. It pulls the metal together. And so you can see where you are by the marks on the metal. I'm working back and forth like that. Any questions so far? You got it? How about you? No problem? Okay. So now you feel of it, feel how it is. And all the time I'm looking at the highlights from the lights shining on the metal to see where I'm at. Now the bullseye pick. Bullseye pick. Now we're going to show you a bullseye pick originally made in Turlock, California. The person died, and then later on Eastwood picked up on it and they duplicated. This is the first one you guys made wasn't worth a damn. I mean, it was a toy. I mean, but this is great. Now this is a good bullseye pick. They come in three sizes. This happens to be a medium. I recommend a medium if you're only going to buy one. Now the medium and the small works really good. The disadvantage of the large one is that it's so long that you're trying to look where you are and you're back here trying to work it. So that's a little bit of a disadvantage. You don't mind if I tell them the real story here?
No. Yeah.
The real truth, okay? So anyway, bullseye pick, you can look at the lights and see where you're at. And you just squeeze the metal and bring up the low places. Now for aluminum, I recommend a blunt pick, which they have. You unscrew this, take it off. This I use for steel, and I use the blunt one for aluminum. Vixen file, ordinary Vixen file. This for a new file feel. Dull.
What's that?
It feels dull. I was going to tell him this file feels dull, but it looks to be new. It just doesn't feel right. Mm. But I don't know what the deal is.
Put it on the dull side. I'll flip it over.
They also make this half round Vixen file, and in these tight radiuses, you see, I should be using a Vixen file if I want to peck and file. That. Now, give me a peck hammer, regular sharp peck hammer. Yes. Danny Bonner, how are you today,
hey,
sir? Excuse me if I don't take the glove off.
You gotta say hi to Paul real quick.
Hi there. Peck hammer, okay? Now, I'm gonna take this peck hammer and we'll pretend like you don't have the bullseye pick. So now you find out where you're at, hold the hammer over here. And I'm reading the highlights so I can see where I'm at. And you can peck and file and bring up any low spots. Pretty good. I'm gonna go around with a dolly, and I'm going to smooth it out like that. I'm gonna just tap a few areas up and down where it's a little bit wavy. It's not bad. Now, when you're first learning how to use a hammer, I recommend you put your thumb on top or your finger, and it helps keep you straighter when you're pounding with it. If you grab it the regular way, chances are you may get a little wobble out of it. So you put your finger on there to help keep it straight. All right, now we're gonna sand it. I'm gonna sand it. I recommend a soft pad with 80 grit on it. This is a DA, and I prefer not to have a DA, but you use a regular machine that is one direction. You know, I use a seven inch, what I call a hog, you know, 7-inch hog with a soft pad, and you have variable speed. So you don't want to turn it real fast. You want to turn it fairly slow. Just hold down on it there. I've got a few areas that are low, not very much, not very bad, but they're a little bit low. And I'm gonna try the bullseye pick and see if I can bring them up. I've got most of them out. We'll try the sander again and see how smooth it is. I was using 80 grit, as you recall, 80 grit. Now, if we want to polish it, now I would go probably straight to 240. I'd go 240 and then 320, 400, and you can get it down so smooth with 320 or 400, then you can put it on a buffer and buff it. Any questions so far? Everybody okay? You got it? She's got it. This lady has it, I'm telling you. She's been listening. And that, did I tell you every day is a school day? You learn something new every day. Now, I'm gonna pass it around. I want you to be careful of the corners. It's a little bit sharp. Don't get your lily white hands cut on that. So start here and just pass it around. Any questions so far? Metal shaping. Okay.
22nd, is that a one-day deal?
Say again?
Your class on the 22nd, is that a one-day deal?
No, 22nd and 23rd is my class. 2 days.
Still open?
Yes, we have open spots, and we furnish lunch. feel my pocket vibrating, and I don't want it to go onto this mic, so we'll just get rid of it. Put it over here. Anyway, any questions? Everybody copying a feel there? So, aluminums. Now you can do the same thing with steel. Do the same, very, very same thing with steel. Takes a little longer, works a little harder because it's a harder surface. Now we're gonna bead roll it.
Bead roll it?
Yeah.
All right.
Now I'm gonna flatten a little a dent that the clamp put in. I'm gonna tap it down where the clamp was. And then I'm going to carefully measure if I can find a marker. We're going to go for an inch and a quarter. I got a jagged edge there, and my finger didn't want to move. It's calibrated for inch, inch and a quarter, inch and a half. Now, what do we use for that circle? That the top to that air cleaner? I use masking tape quite often to pick up a nice radius. Okay. There we go. Okay, I have placed a line around the outer edge, and it is approximately inch and a quarter, and put a radius on it. Okay, now we're going to use a bead roller. Okay, tighten it up. Now I'm gonna go get my gloves. Okay. I recommend you weld a little T-handle onto this bolt. You know, get a little T-handle on it so you can turn it without using the nice, beautiful pliers that he has here.
Shop tools.
Shop tool. Okay.
Booth tools.
Now, roll it. Slow and steady. Let me get it started. A little faster on the straight. All right, slow in the turns. You should not try to bead roll the whole thing at one time, because the guy on the handle, he has to grunt a little bit. So you bring it down a little bit at a time and go around it maybe three times by tightening it up in between each time, of course. A little more. Okay, now let's tighten her up. We won't need very much more. Just another half a turn should be okay. Okay, crank away. Almost grunting, aren't you?
The steering wheel, right?
A little tight. Now, I recommend putting a steering wheel on here instead of the regular handle. The steering wheel, you get more leverage with less work. I think we got it.
Good?
I think so.
All right.
Now let's go around this turn. Okay.
On that.
Yeah, you were pretty strong with that. Okay, now we went around it with a bead roller and created a nice little edge, a nice little stiffening edge. I'll take a look at that. Now we still have a little wrinkle in the edge here. We're going to try to take that out by bending a little bit on the little brake, the little hand brake over here. I'm going to first hand me that slapping file. I'm going to take the file and deburr this edge that was giving me the trouble with my finger a while ago. Rest of it's pretty good. Sure, do you?
No,
okay. All right, I'm going to take the marker. Now we want to I'm going to go around the edge and mark a 3/8 line on it. I'm going to take the tin snips and just barely, no, I don't use those.
Left and right only.
Left and right only. Forget those yellow ones. They just don't do it. Now, on Friday afternoon, he'll probably give you a special price on some of these tools that I used, and I'll autograph them for you. Okay, we deburred and rounded the edges a little tiny bit with the tin snips. Bring it down. Okay, I'm tightening up the edges. Now we're going to bring it up maybe 30 degrees. Just kind of, you kind of bounce it and look at it. Okay. Bring it down. Okay. Now I'm going to do all four sides. Now we're going to have a little trivia contest. A trivia, custom car trivia contest. Got it. Bring it down. Got it? Okay, we've made a panel, which I'm going to autograph, and one of you will take it home. Any questions so far? Use the tin snips, we use the sander, we use the little brake, we use the bead roller.
If you use the die too tight, you can just cut through this?
If you go too tight, it could cut it, yes.
So you have to know how far?
On aluminum. You bring it up little by little. Now, the last time we had it a little bit too hard, you know, it was a little bit too hard, but it works out okay.
So this particular thickness of aluminum, only if you use that die. You can't use a heavier die because it's going to crack it.
No. You can use the wider die. You have a wider one for this?
Yeah we do. It's
show me.
Sizes.
Let me see. He's gonna look for some more dies. We can use different width of bead rolling. Okay, were you watching? Cool, I know you were watching. Okay, now, the trivia, don't have them with you, okay. Custom car, early customizers, okay, Bill Cushenberry. Some of you heard of Bill Cushenberry, early customizer. What was the most famous car that Bill Cushenberry did? Most famous car that Bill Cushenberry did. Okay, how about Gene Winfield? Most famous car that I... Jade Idol.
He got it.
Okay, you get the panel.
What was Cushenberry's?
Silhouette, and then the second one was the Carcraft Dream Car, I think they called it. Here we go.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
How did he sign up for your class?
What?
How did he sign up?
You see me after the deal.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, any questions so far?
Sorry.
No, I just wanted to say hi.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Nice to see you. Hi there, young lady.
Hi,
how are you?
I'm Ashley Bacon, his wife.
Are you really Ashley?
Yes.
This is Ashley, everybody. This is Ashley, his wife. Okay?
Hi.
Do you have a piece of metal to shrink and stretch? Got an angle already bent?
No.
You want to bend it? A little bit narrow, isn't it? You have a dry erase board. Want to get that out? I'm going to show you a couple things on the on a dry erase board here. Okay. Let's bring it right up here. How's that? Got a rag? Now, I'll show you.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was just talking to him.
Will you listen to me, please?
I'm sorry. Now, please don't kick me out of class.
Okay, now raise your hand if you want to speak again. Okay? It's all right. Here, we got it. We got it right here. Now, a couple of tools that I want you to go home and make. Okay? First of all, a workstation. Okay, 20 inches by about 12 inches this way. I recommend 1.5 inches, 2 inches, 1.5 inches or 2 inches thickness. You can get by with 1 inch, but no less than 1 inch. You just want a nice heavy piece, and I radius these corners usually with two different radiuses. Two different radiuses. Now you can pound metal onto these different radiuses. Make sure you keep this one nice and sharp and square back here. So now we're gonna, here's the trick thing that you do is you do not weld this to a base, especially if you're working in a home garage and you want your neighbors to talk to you at all. You know, you wanna put a piece of rubber or 40-pound felt paper in between the steel and the base. So what I do is I make an angle iron base that may look like this, and this is regular angle iron under here, and so on. And you bolt this, you bolt it, and I would drill it with half-inch 13 bolts, half-inch 13, put 4 bolts in it, and you put rubber or paper in between the two. Now on this base, you can put a flat plate, quarter inch plate, and then your base will go down from that, whatever you want to put on the floor down here. And then, so this bolts up underneath there, obviously. So now your base is coming down. Then you make a tray. You can also use 1.5 inches angle iron. Make a tray like this that goes in here. Then put perforated metal in here just so the dust doesn't collect. And then you put your dollies in here. Then you can use tubing, little pieces of round tubing all the way across here for your hammers. All the way around there. Put your hammers and your dollies in here. And this from your thick piece, put this down maybe 8 or 10 inches so you can still bend metal over around, work all the way around it. And you got your hammers and dollies in there. Then when you go down, put your base. Then here on your base, if you're gonna put casters on it, you put 3 instead of 4. 3 casters, and it'll self-level on uneven floors. All Lockheed, Martin, Grumman, all the aircraft companies, 3 dollies, 3 casters on the bottom. Okay? Everybody all right so far? You got it?
Got it.
Okay. Now, a next tool that's very easy to make, it just takes a little work and a lot of torch work, this is a railroad rail. Top view.
Yeah.
top view, side view, railroad rail. Now, when you get ready to put it on a stand, you bold it instead of welding it on a stand. So you a lot of torch work to get this in there and grind it and so forth. Beautiful tool. All right, one more. Make a pipe anvil. 5 or 6 inch pipe. 3.5 or 4 inch pipe. And a 2 inch. Now you put these kind of low. In other words, here would be your center of your pipe. You want to put this one down here and this one down here, not up high. Now you're able to, you can weld this or bold it, but if you, either way, you want to put a gap in here is 3/32. I'm not really writing that right. 3/32. 3/32, okay? 14 gauge metal. Put a little piece here and a little piece here and weld it up if you want to. Now you can put sheet metal in here, just shove it in and bend it over that circle. Put sheet metal here, bend it over this circle. Isn't that great? You've seen it. It works super. So your 3/32 gap, it allows you to put in, you can go up to 14 gauge if it's in small pieces, but you're not gonna bend a piece of 14 gauge by hand across that, depends on how long. Now that's the big question, how long do you make it? Okay, mine is 52 inches inside because a rocker, I make rockers for a Mercury and they're 51.5 inches. But you can go 3 feet or you can go 4 feet or whatever. I don't recommend over 6. A friend of mine made one longer than 6 feet, and then you put it in here, it springs. You see the tubing, especially the 2 inch, it'll spring too much.
Have you tried solid stock?
Oh yeah, works great. Fabulous solid stock.
As far as springing goes.
Oh yeah, no, it works just fine. As they say, it works bitching. But you know, it costs a lot more, okay? Now what I do recommend, if you can afford it, is tubing instead of pipe. Tubing instead of pipe. Now tubing is a thicker wall.
Is that like a DOM?
Yes, DOM tubing. It'll have a 1/4 inch wall, things like that. So, and then I mount this on a single pole on one end and a double on the back end. Like that. The reason I do that is because sometimes you bring something over, you want to bend a hood over it, then these legs are not in your way. Then I also bolted mine here on this particular one. You put big, heavy 1/2 inch plates and 2 nice 1/2 inch bolts in here, and you bolt it on there. Then you can set it up so that it has a groove or a line or a ridge so that you know the gap is right. And then I have 2 more of these. You see, so I have 5 different diameters.
Technically, you could almost put a plate on the back end of that and put a three wheel on it. So you could
absolutely, anything you want. I will let you do that. Did I tell you that every day is a school day?
Yeah,
don't forget it. Every day is a school day.
Sure. Yeah. Say 18 gauge steel, 4 feet long.
I use 18 gauge all the time. 18 gauge cold roll. You do not want to use hot roll. Forget it. Hot roll has a black slag on it, and if you're going to chrome it or paint it, you have to grind it all off. You cannot paint successfully over hot roll steel, so use cold roll. So I use 18 gauge cold roll on every repair part, fabrication, you know, everything that I make. Any questions? Okay, that's it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks.